Has anybody got a match? Thanks. Now I can light an old gold for a treat instead of a treatment and listen to songs by Sinatra.
Night and day, you are the one. Only you neath the moon or under the sun.
Hello, neighbors. Hi, boys and girls. It's Old Gold Night again, and we're alerting all song stations from the sentimental sands of the South to the ski track slopes under the northern lights. It's a demand performance tonight for everything from rhythm to the gentle snobbery of that standing room only set of song stylers, the Pied Pipers.
Night and day, under the high of me.
And of course, there's the sad certainty of being stalked down Sing Song Alley and of being trapped like a clinker by that fugitive from a pair of bobby socks, the Boston Buff boy, that melancholy bane of slow thinkers' existence, Fred the Allen himself. And in the meantime, there you have it. Songs, Sinatra, and of course, the swell music of Axe Stordahl and Company. I used to love to hold you when the lights were down low, but it's all over now. You used to whisper little things to set me aglow, but it's all over now. I listen to you tell me little white lies, never thought that you might deceive. Whoever would have doubted those innocent eyes and all the little kisses that you made me believe? Remember how I planned a little home by the stream where we'd spend every day? You must have thought me crazy when I painted that dream, 'cause you threw it away. I kinda wish that things would be different, have a happy ending somehow. But I guess you only took me for a ride in the dark, and it's all over now. See the role in Acts. The night is young, and December's children are mellow under a midwinter moon. Yep, that's the way it listens. Good, kids. Something sentimental and smooth. Some simple words and soothing sounds, and you've got the set. She's got the size, and you've got the script for the biggest love story of the week.
You keep coming back like a song. A song that keeps saying, remember the sweet used to be that was once you and me. Keeps coming back like an old melody. The perfume of roses in May. Returns to my room in December. Where forgotten things belong, you keep coming back like a song.
Now, neighbors, if you'll shed the mups from those shell-like ears, Danny Seymour will sell you on getting back in the old gold standard.
Well, right now, this minute, I'm going to do something that may overthrow the entire radio business. I'm going to read you a cigarette commercial, but I'm not going to say a word about cigarette laboratory tests or quote you statistics or make medical claims. Great. I'm not even going to mention throat irritation. All I'm going to say, simply and honestly, is this. Ladies and gentlemen, if you want a really wonderful cigarette, just try an Old Gold. Old Golds are the finest blend of the finest tobaccos money can buy, made by folks with nearly 200 years in quality tobaccos behind them. Why, every bit of tobacco science known to man, every advanced technique and control, is concentrated on one thing in an Old Gold. To give you a cigarette that's absolutely the last word in rich, mellow, deep-smoking enjoyment. By all means, take care of yourself and your throat and everything else. But listen, we're talking about the unique pleasures of tobacco. And that's why we've been telling you all along. Anytime you want to smoke for the grand fun of it, anytime you want a treat instead of a treatment, treat yourself to a pack of Old Golds.
You've just said a pack full, Danny boy. Yes, neighbors, anytime you want a treat instead of a treatment, OGs. Old Buttermilk Sky, I'm keeping my eye peeled on you. What's the good word tonight? Yes, friends, that Old Buttermilk Sky, which means we're about to take off for the deep blue yonder with the grooviest quartet ever to churn up an atmosphere into a thing of mellow beauty. Pilot the pipes, pass the pixie pasteurization, pronto.
Sky, I'm keeping my eye peeled on you. What's the good word tonight? Gonna be mellow tonight. Oh, buttermilk sky, can't you see my little donkey and me? We're happy as a Christmas tree, heading for the one I love. I'm gonna pop her the question, that question. Do you, darling, do you do? It'll be easy, so easy.
If I could only bank on you.
Oh, buttermilk sky, I'm a-telling you why. Now you know, keep it in mind tonight.
Keep a-brushing those clouds from sight.
I'm needing you most. Hang a moon above her hitching post. Hitch me to the one I love. You can if you try. Don't tell me no lies. Will you be mellow and bright tonight? Buttermilk
neighbors, this tune is as difficult to get away from as a happy memory. Last week, while Boogeyman John was playing hide the coal bucket, we were bundling up some old bills and manuscripts for the furnace when we happened across this melody.
We brought it along tonight in the hope that you too can have the fun of a few minutes with an old friend.
There's nothing left for me of days that used to be. I live in memory among my souvenirs. Some letters tied with blue, a photograph or two. I see a rose from you among my souvenirs. A few more tokens rest within my treasure chest. And though they do their best to give me consolation, I count them all apart, and as the teardrops start, I find a broken heart among my souvenirs.
Well, neighbors, let's turn the page of the songbook and come up to chapter 10.
Pardon me, sir. If you're going to turn a page, may I wet your finger?
By Fred Allen. Fred, what are you doing on the premises?
Frankie, where have you been keeping yourself? I've been trying to see you all week.
Well, you know how it is when I come to New York, Fred. I get pretty busy.
I rented a dirty raincoat and stood in front of Toots Shaw's tonight. You never came out.
Well, the service at Tootsie's is pretty slow, Fred.
Really?
You know, last night it took me 2 hours to get a minute's stay.
2 hours?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And tonight I ordered a cottage pudding. When I left, the foundation wasn't even up.
Well, I bought an autograph book and waited outside your hotel all one day, thank you.
You missed me again?
Yes. Some guy saw me with the autograph book. He pulled me into a doorway and started beating me over the head until I took his autograph.
Who was the guy? Perry Como?
No, it was Singing Sam.
Singing Sam. Say, isn't that the name Crosby uses on transcriptions?
That's Singing Samuel, I think it is. But about me, Frank.
I'm sorry, Fred. Go ahead.
Well, look, I wore a pork pie hat and hung around the radio studio all last Wednesday. You got away again.
Well, if you wanted to see me, Fred, why didn't you come over the Waldorf? I'm over at the Wedgwood room each night, you know.
Well, I know I tried the Waldorf, Frank. I got dressed up. I put on my double-breasted raccoon windbreaker. My lemon-colored knickerbockers. My suede spats with the cat's eye buttons.
No bow tie?
No bow tie. I was carrying my dress cane.
Dress cane?
Yes, it's the hind leg of a gazelle. Orson Welles, in a moment of weakness, the first one he ever had, gave me the cane last Christmas.
Well, tell me, Fred, what happened?
Well, as I walked into the Waldorf, the gazelle leg came to life and kicked the doorman.
No.
Well, sir, when I came to, I was going up Park Avenue. The gazelle leg was walking ahead of me.
Tell me, Fred, how did you get in here tonight?
Well, Frank, promise you won't tell.
I won't tell a soul.
I took an oath I was over 21. I showed them my teeth were all out, so I couldn't whistle. And I also promised when you started singing, I wouldn't scream.
Now, that's very nice. And what's on your mind?
Well, Frankie, you are looking great.
Oh, you're kidding.
No, no, no. You're getting fat, Frank. Your Adam's apple used to stand out straight.
That's so.
Now it's hanging down over your collar. Last year, if you recall, your face was thin and sharp.
Yes, I know, Fred. Last year, you know, I could have shaved one side of my face with the other.
You used to look like something you'd find on the floor after the Inner Sanctum program was over.
I see what you mean. You know, I could have posed for the picture on that ad. Send this boy to camp.
Right. Tell me, Frankie, as friend to friend, what made this great change in you?
Wheaties. The breakfast of champions.
Oh, good. Why didn't you eat Wheaties last year?
Well, I didn't have the strength to open the box.
You know, I've been listening to your programs lately. They are terrific.
Thank you, Fred.
And your voice better every day.
Well, thank you,
and
sir.
Your last picture.
Fred?
Yes, Frank?
How much do you need, kid?
Who needs money? With 6 telephones, the pot of gold has got to call me someday.
Quit stalling, Fred. I kind of feel like an ear of corn. After you butter me up, you'll give me the bite.
Now, look, Frank.
With all this flattery, Fred, you must want something. Now, tell Frankie.
Well, I'll confess, Frankie. I read on the music page of the Hobo News that you are opening a new music publishing firm.
Oh, Fred, don't tell me you have written the song.
Well, I don't...
I haven't even got an office yet. And every schnook in town I meet has a song.
Well, now, look, Frank,
The head waiter in Lindy's wrote a song. It's called, I'm Sending Best Wishes with His Little Dish of Knishes.
But, Frank...
And the guy at the parking lot wrote a song about the smiling Irishman, Clancy with a laughing face.
Frank, look,
And even my barber wrote a song, To Each His Home. And Fred, now you.
Frank, you are not talking to a schmo. This isn't Joe Blow in person, you know. I can write songs. Why, I'm a friend of Nick Kenny's.
Well, listen. Now tell me. You do Patty poems on
yes,
the side?
Yes, only by appointment.
Tell me, what songs have you written?
Well, have you heard, I'm looking for the guy who began the beguine to see if I can get him to stop it?
You wrote that, Fred?
Yes, Frank, and I dedicated a ballad to you.
What is my song called?
Is That You Under Your Skin? My new song.
Oh, I'm sorry, Fred.
Well,
I'm
all
sorry.
All right, all right. Hildegard says, if I'll translate it into French.
Hildegard?
Hildegard. I had a long talk with her interpreter this morning before he left for the UN.
Oh, now, just a second. If Hildegard wants your song, that's good enough for me.
Frank, you mean?
There's an old saying, when Hildegard sings a ditty, it's a hit in every city.
Yes. Confucius said that, as I recall. You know, Hildegard sang the Star Spangled Banner. That's how it caught on.
Yes, I was. What is your song about, Fred?
Well, what are all the hit songs today, Frankie? Songs about food.
Food songs?
Yes, they've got an awful lot of coffee in Brazil. My Sugar Is So Refined, Chiquita Banana.
Uh-huh. What is your song called? Old Man Liver? Wowee.
I have written... Wowee Flat. I have written... Don't mind, I took it down a half a tone. I have written a mess of food songs, Frank. Remember my big hit, A Pot Roast, Some Coleslaw, and You?
Oh, yes.
And that other one, You Look Through the Lettuce Into My Heart.
Oh, that was a smash.
That was a smash. Yes. And Poultice Fisher held it over. The song of the week. With the 40 cent special.
But, Fred, I am going to open a music publishing house, not a delicatessen.
Now, look, Frank. Look, Frank, what is the biggest song around?
Let me see now. Oh, yes, of course. Ole Buttermilk Sky.
My song is a sequel.
You have a sequel to Ole Buttermilk Sky?
It's called Acidophilus Moon.
Well, how does it go, Fred?
Mr. Stordahl, if you please. Seated one day in a health food store, I looked up from my carrots and peas Two eyes met mine, or a letter's leaf. She was munching her vitamin B. I spelled out love with my soybeans. She blushed in her watercress spray. As I whispered caloric nothings in my own vegetarian way. Acidophilus moon, just a sour lagoon.
Now, wait a minute.
You big wild
spittoon. Fred,
well, what's
please,
what's just
wrong?
A minute.
Frank, what's wrong? My voice?
Fred, you couldn't stay on pitch if you were climbing up a pine tree.
But my song, Frank.
Fred, that chorus. Why, you've stolen the whole melody of Buttermilk Sky.
Frank, live and let live, boy. Who will know?
Hoagy Carmichael.
Hoagy Carmichael, one man.
And his lawyer.
Well, they're out in Hollywood, Frankie. All they hear are those California songs.
California songs?
If you knew Azusa like I know Azusa, La Cucamonga. What do you say, Frank? Will you publish my song?
I can give you my answer in one word.
Yes?
No.
Oh, now look, if you won't publish it, how about singing my song on your program?
I think I'll stick to my memory songs.
Oh, Frank, the way you sing those old songs. Look at Axel's band. 50 violins, 20 harps, 10 electric guitars. With the man from Consolidated Edison standing in front of the band checking the meter. Your memory songs sound like Spike Jones with amnesia, boy.
Yes, but Fred, the people seem to like the old songs.
Ah, but you have the wrong approach, Fred. If you ever sing that old song in my Merry Oldsmobile, it'll come out like the new Studebaker. You won't know the beginning from the end.
Well, how should I sing it, Fred?
Old songs should be sung the way they were sung in the old days. The way we used to sing them in vaudeville.
Well, that was a little before my time, Fred.
Granted, Frankie. Here is a copy, though, of my Merry Oldsmobile. Now, I'll sing it with you to show you what I mean.
Okay, Axel, let's go.
Come away with me, Lucille, in my merry Oldsmobile. Down the road of life we'll fly, automobubbling you and I. To the church we'll swiftly steal, then our wedding bells we'll peal. You can go as far as you like with me in my merry Oldsmobile.
Take me up along with you, my darling, do, and we will go up high into a latitude about as near as anybody who has ever reached the sky. We will sail around the moon and planet, making love and hugging every time we stand it, with nobody in the airplane except the minister and you and I. We will float a little flying boat a little while we roll a little slender note a little subsequently passing through the sky and having lots of fun. We will go into the sweet skies of blue and ice. We will figure out the duality, turning to old terra firma. We will be as one.
Together,
you can go as far as you like with me in my merry old hobby.
Say, listen. Are you tired of all this talk about cigarette laboratory tests and medical claims about smoking and stuff about throat irritation? Do you want to smoke just for the fun of it? Just for the pleasure of it? Then look into a pack of Old Golds. No test tubes, no thermometers, no statistics. All you'll find in a pack of Old Golds are 20 smooth, delicious, and fragrant cigarettes. And folks, we promise you a downright miracle of taste and flavor in every Old Gold you put to your lips. We promise you the marvelous pleasure of smooth, mellow smoke rolling luxuriously on your tongue. Try an Old Gold. Then you'll know why we've been saying all along, if you want a treat instead of a treatment, treat yourself to Old Golds. Ask for them at your tobacco counters. Look for them in the cigarette vending machines.
Around the corner and down the canyon of light, there's a can of film being spun into a tapestry of charm and beauty that tries in its small and lovely way to conjure up the gracious ghosts of a lifetime and let us share in part some of the beauty of one man's life.
The picture is called Till the Clouds Roll By, and it is the life story of the great composer, Jerry Kern, a life that makes our own lives bigger and richer. For in all our lives, will there be a song more beloved than this one?
Here we all work on the Mississippi. Here we all work while the white folk play, pulling them boats from the dawn till sunset, getting no rest till the judgment day. Don't look up and don't look down, you don't dare make the white boss frown. Bend your knees and bow your head and pull that rope until you're dead. Let me go away from the Mississippi. Let me go away from the white man boss. Show me that stream called the River Jordan. That's the old stream that I long to cross. Old Man River, that old man river, he must know something, but he don't say nothing. He just keeps rolling. He keeps on rolling along. He don't plant potatoes, and he don't plant cotton. And them what plants some is soon forgotten. But old man River just keeps rolling along. You and me, we sweat and strain. Bodies all aching and racked with pain. Coat that barge, lift that bale. You'll get a little drunk and you land in jail. I get weary and so sick of crying. I'm tired of living, but I'm feared of dying. And
time to grab the trolley, neighbors, and head for home. Before we go, we'd like to thank Fred Allen for brightening our corner this evening and Tenderleaf Tea for letting him brighten. We've had good fun being with you again, and we hope that you'll all go with us again next week for a treat instead of a treatment, as per schedule. In the meantime, the best friends and...
Put your dreams away.
Good night, Nancy. Good night, Frankie. So long, everybody.
This is CBS, the Columbia Broadcasting System.